Two more areas placed under the control of the Philippine Po Body due to security concerns. These are Misamis Occidental and Pilar Town in the province of Abra. COMELEC Chairman Saidamen Pangarungan says the two areas have been riddled with election-related violence ahead of the polls. Several other towns and cities, including Marawi in Mindanao, had earlier been placed under COMELEC control. An update now on the overseas voting of Filipinos in New York. Consul General El Mercato says two out of the three vote counting machines that malfunctioned earlier this week have now been fixed. Two VCMs are currently being used for ballot feeding, while one is on standby. According to Cato, many Filipinos are also choosing to personally deliver their accomplished ballot to the consulate instead of mailing them back.
Parang gusto nila makasigurado na talagang makukuha naman yung balota. Our personnel are willing to work overtime just to be able to catch up kasi ang dami-daming mga balota yung dumarating. Ano? Kaya kailangan maghabol kami ngayon and I think we're confident naman that we would be able to proceed with our schedule. Ano? With three out of four vote counting machines operational.
As for those who have yet to receive their ballots by mail, Cato says they will start allowing on-site voting this Saturday. The camp of Vice President Lenny Robredo, unfazed by the endorsement given by religious group Iglesia Ni Cristo to rival Bongbong Marcos and his running mate, Sara Duterte Carpio. The INC, which has millions of followers around the world, is known to vote as a bloc. But the Vice President's team says they're not overly concerned about this development, pointing out Marcos also got the backing of INC in the 2016 elections, but still lost to Robredo.
We respect the decision. It's always the choice of any group, religious or not, to support a particular candidate in the same way that we have received the support of certain other groups from the Catholic Church, for example. We expected this, and in 2016, despite the endorsement of our rival candidate, VP Lenny was able to pull off a victory. So it's something we respect, it's something we expected, but it's not something we are overly concerned with.
The camp of presidential aspirant Senator Manny Pacquiao, optimistic he can pull off an upset against survey frontrunners on Election Day. His campaign manager, Buddy Zamora, cites Pacquiao's improved preference rating, which slightly rose to 7% based on Pulse Asia's final pre-election survey. He also says Pacquiao is relying on the vote of other Christian organizations.
The support of the body of Christ, which we believe number about at this moment, we are estimating is about 14 million population here in the Philippines. So we're expecting perhaps about half from them to generate votes for us. In my estimate, we have 80% of the Christian vote for 2022. Brother Eddie Villanueva is backing us up completely.
An analyst says, historically, the bloc vote of Iglesia Ni Cristo is considered solid and boosts the campaign of the endorsed candidate. But the Dumanhit of Strat-based ADR Institute says this endorsement can still be negated by other blocs of the Catholic Church. He also warned Iglesia Ni Cristo against using its influence for political gain.
It's not also good, really, when a religious group uses its influence towards its followers. And some would say they're not being forced, but I know for a fact in my conversation through the years as a political observer that the followers of the church looks at this as important to their faith. This has been discerned mm-hmm. by their leaders. But when you turn it into a political tool, that's where the danger is. When you use this endorsement and gain patronage from this, this might not be good for Philippine democracy because it creates a situation whereby a certain church and a state works together.
For a sociologist, the Iglesia Ni Cristo block vote can make or break a close fight in the elections. Dr. Jail Cornelio says in the 2016 polls, 70% of INC members adhered to the bloc vote and voted for President Rodrigo Duterte. He says there's a political and economic wisdom behind the INC's choice of candidate.
Being allied with a politician, somebody in power, can protect their own interests as well, especially with respect to land and property and so forth. So now we don't only see it as a political alliance building, but also as an assertion of its presence in Philippine society. Certainly there's politics to it, certainly there's economics to it, but certainly also there's a religious dimension to it, you know, attracting more people who will join.
Vice President Leni Robredo and her running mate, Senator Francis Pangilinan, gain another key endorsement with just days to go before the elections. Catholic group Clergy for the Moral Choice has announced it will be supporting the tandem. The group, which is composed of over 1,000 Filipino bishops, priests, and deacons, says Robredo and Pangilinan are true servant leaders, even in their private lives. It also cites the candidates' clean track record, saying they were never involved in any anomaly. Presidential candidate Faisal Maundato vows to prioritize the agriculture sector should he win the race for Malacañang. Speaking at the COMELEC panel interviews, Maundato said pushing for reforms in the sector will not only help farmers but also promote food security and economic recovery of the country. He wants government not to rely too much on importation since the Philippines is an agricultural country.
Hindi lang tayo uutang ng mga doon sa mga foreign bank dahil yan ay mas lalong nagigipit ang ating bayan, mas lalong nagigipit yung mga kababayan natin. Mm-hmm. Kaya gusto ko yung dati na agrikultura ay gawa ng paraan ng ating gobyerno ng sagayon magkaroon ng suporta sa ekonomiya ng ating bansa. Mm-hmm.